What is up, people? Welcome to a mod spotlight about the mod EFab. The mod is made by MC Jetty, which also made RF Tools, The Presonance, and other kind of mods that are just insane and good all the time. So this thing will be good, that's for sure. This mod spotlight is for developers. So if you're looking for how you can use these blocks as a player, go look at my other mod spotlight for the players. So as a developer for your modpack, you will be mostly using text editors, but there's also other parts. So if you're here, you want to know how you can create beautiful recipes such as, stuff like this and stuff like this one here without too much difficulty. So currently we are in the game, but most of this part will take place into my text editor because I need to show you the syntaxes and things like that. So the first thing you're going to need is you're going to do EFab save default. This is going to give you a file that you will have a couple of default recipes so you can look at it, and it's also going to be the file that you're going to use to make all your recipes inside of it. So this is going to be into your config folder of your modpack, and that's where you're going to do it. Second thing you might want to do is you need to have information about the items that you currently have and that you want to make. There are three ways to get the information about the items that you have. I will talk mostly about one of them as it's the most simple one, and you probably can do it as you're making a mod pack, so you should have this installed into your mod pack, which is Craft Tweaker and Mod Tweaker. So this will allow you to actually modify the recipe for multiple mods and stuff like that. So if you do have this, you can do empty hand, and it's going to give you the item with the tags in there. So you're going to get your fluid name here, so mana, and the amount in there. So what you have in here is your NBT data, and this is the name of the item. Pretty handy little command. There's another way you can dump all the items. And the third way is with entity data, which you would normally drop it on the ground and then do something like entity data at entity type equal item with the radius equal 3 or something like this. Well, it's something of the sort, which would give you what you have on the ground. But if you are about to use this mod, you're probably going to have Mod Tweaker installed and Craft Tweaker, so you're going to be able to just change the recipe that way, and it's a good way of doing it. So now that we've got the items information, let's get into my text editor to see what are the next things that we can do. The first file we're going to look at is the efab.cfg. It contains all the general settings related to the mod, and everything can be changed. So I tried to zoom a little bit for you guys to be able to see a little bit more what is happening, because it tends to be a little bit small when you read code. So over here, we've got the general section, which is the only section in this file. And it contains pretty much everything that can be changed in the mod, except the recipes, this we're going to look at just after. So, ambient boiler temperature. We're going to look at a couple of them. It is important that you stick to the range that is possible. It is written for all of them. So if you do a mistake, just reread the comment, and it's going to tell you that you pretty much made a mistake. So let's start with ambient boiler temperature. It is at 20 degrees Celsius. But to be able to boil something, you need to reach 100 Celsius. So this is important because depending on what you have here for the boiler cool down temperature and rise temperature, this thing might be a little bit slower than you might anticipate when it goes up to be able to actually steam something. because, well, you need to put that to 100, and the maximum that you can go is also set up over here. The maxed boiler temperature is 200, which you can go all the way to 1,000, but that means that if you put it to 1,000, it's going to come down slower to the base temperature, which is going to be available to use longer after you remove your heat source. So this is one of the things that is necessary to look a little bit at if you want to tweak a little bit these temperatures. You've got the sound volume, not temperatures, volumes over here that you can change for a couple of the machines. There is the craft animation boost, so when it's going to craft, it's going, you know, how long is it going to show you the crafting for? The speed up, so it's going to become faster. Crafter delays, the mana rotation boost, which number of ticks that the rotating sphere will speed up during mana crafting, which is pretty cool. The effect is really nice. And every tick the rotation sphere will speed up during the mana crafting, and of course the spin down as well. Over here we also have the max mana, so how much mana will the receptacle will actually hold is here. The rotation speed of the sphere, of this receptacle spheres, and the max mana usage. So how much mana per tick can it actually give to your crafting? So here we already looked at the max boiler temperature, craft animation speed, again. And at the bottom here, we're getting into if you want to let your players speed up their recipe by their own by crafting more blocks. So here we have the pipes. At the basic one, it says that you can only have 2 to speed up the liquid crafting operations. But you can put this to 64, and instead of being 2 times faster, it would be 64 times faster. But you gotta take in mind that if you allow them to do this, more blocks into a multi-block structure will eventually lag the platform that you're using. If it's your server or your single player, it will lag eventually because all of these have connections together. So be aware of this and test things before you release it. Over here, the maximum speed bonus on a crafting operation you can get by adding multiple machine parts, 1 to 64. Default is 4. Again, same way as this one, you can boost it to make things go faster. Again, things that are mostly visible. RF control input per tick. So RF control is how much is it going to be able to output for your recipes every tick. So you've got it here. You've got your max storage you can have in there. The same thing for your RF storage box. How much can it grab? The internal flow and RF per ticks that it can do. Here we got a little bit of how long is the beep going to play, the machine, the spark, the steam, the wheel boost, the steam wheel speed up. All these things are pretty much auditory or visual. They do not change anything. Over here, you get the spin down, which, so speed at which the speed of the wheel will decrease again. Tank 2 capacity. This is the advanced tank. You can change it to between 1 and 1 million. I would keep, 64,000, 128,000, 192,000. These are a good amount. And this is the normal tank, which is defaulted at 16,000. But you can, again, increase it as you want, or make it even smaller. Tick allowed without mana. Again, it's mana. Without RF, it's 1. This does not take into account one of the block. That is the power optimizer. This is not going to care if you have no longer any RF. But if you don't have the power optimizer, this thing is going to say, we don't have RF for a tick, we stop. Vanilla craft time. How long does it take to craft vanilla stuff? 1 tick. Over here, we've got vanilla crafting allowed, true or false. You can remove all the vanilla recipe or put them if you want. And here, water steam crafting consumption. How much millibucket of water will it use every tick for the craft? So let's say if you have a 10 tick craft, it's going to take 50 millibucket of water. But over here we get water steam start amount. So this thing is not going to be able to do any Steam-related crafting recipe if it does not have the amount that you have here to start the recipe. So at the moment, it's half a bucket. So this thing, even though it takes 50, would not be able to start if it has like 250 millibucket. So this one, change it however you want. If we look at the EFab recipe, the JSON that you should have extracted the last time that you saw the first part of the video, it will give you a file containing a couple of recipes. Over here, I made one myself to show you a little bit of everything that you can do with this config file, this JSON file, to be honest. So over here, I've got one object going along and it has a lot of things in there. So I will show you a couple of ways you can make your things while using NBTData, metadata, or dictionary, empty blocks of space in your crafting grid, all of those things. So there are two different types. They're shaped and shapeless. So you could do shapeless. So if you had one item in here like this, you could place it anywhere in the grid and it would do what you want. But we're going to work with shaped for the moment. I will show an example of shapeless a little bit after. We have the output, which is an item. So you got your mod name, then you got your item name, and you get your metadata here if there's any, and you could add also NBTData under it if you needed to do so. And we're going to look at the NBTData when we're in the input map over here. So here we have the input. The input is in brackets with a string, another string, and another string. Of course, like I've done before, you could, if you wanted in a shapeless one, you could just have this. And this is going to say we just need one item. What you could do in a shaped is remove a couple of them, like this, and it's going to allow you to place it vertically in any of the three columns, and it's still going to work, which I will show you a little bit above because I've done such and it worked. So you could also, if you want an empty spot, you could put an item here at the bottom, which would be an empty spot, or you could leave an empty space, and this will mean that this one needs to be empty. So then when you want to place items in there, you're not just going to do like your items, comma, your item, comma, you're going to put a letter, which is going to be represented in the input map over here. You can use from A to Z and capital A to Z as well. So if you need more entry, I don't know what you're doing because you get 9 spot and you get more than 50 possible input maps. It is important to know that if you have a letter here and you don't have over here, it will throw an error when you start your modpack. If you have one here and it is not there, it will throw an error. If you don't respect JSON format, it will throw an error. If you're missing a part, let's say you're using RF and you don't have the RF timer, it will throw an error. So it will tell you when you're making something wrong, but it is good to know in advance when you make something. So over here, we've got lil, and lil, which are represented below here in the input map. So I, in here, is represented for ingot iron. This is an OR dictionary. We have M, which is an item specific with a metadata. So M here will be this one, which is mana dust, primal mana dust. And over here we got M as a capital letter. And this one's for the mana bucket. So how do you do your NBTData? It is really important that you escape any of those quotes or double quotes, actually double quotes because you cannot use single quotes. So you need to escape your double quotes inside and your NBTData needs to be inside curly brackets when you do it. So it is a string. Inside of the string, there's curly brackets, and inside of there's your object. So this is an object stringified to be able to be used NDNBT tag. This is really simple. You can get this one, like I said, by using the command, by dumping the files, by using an NBT Explorer program. All of these will work. And here, well, you just have L, which is a normal letter stuff. After that, you will have your time. How long will the crafting works? If you don't want it to take any time, put this thing to zero. But the point is that it's going to work in conjunction with other things that you have. So you might not want to put it to zero. This thing is in tick. So this thing here is 10 seconds because there's 20 ticks in a second. And then I multiply it by 10. It is 10 seconds. You have your tiers. What do you need? And you can see it at the top. Right now, this is this recipe that you can see at the top right. This is what you need for the recipe. So I need RF, I need liquid, I need a gearbox, I need computing power, I need steam, I need all of the upgrades. So the upgrade armory, the upgrade digital, the magic, the power, and all of those things are going to be needed. You could, if you wanted, just put these four. You could just put one. Really important again. Do not put a comma. It's a trailing comma, so it's going to cause an error. It's not a valid format for JSON. So this is in a square bracket. It's like a list. You just list your things in there. Over here, we get RF per tick, which works in conjunction with the RF over here. So this is every tick you're going to need 60 RF. So if you want to cap it at like 5,000 RF and you get 200 seconds, you do the math and you place it here. I will not do any math. But this is the way it works. But currently, it's going to calculate for you how much RF maximum you need. Well, what is the total RF the recipe will be needing is going to be calculated by multiplying this one to this one. This is quite simple. Over here, you get your fluid. Your fluid is a square bracket, but inside you're going to need your curly bracket with the fluid name. So fluid, the name in here, the amount of the fluid that you need. And as you can see in the little video at the top right of the screen, it's going to have two little boxes with the two little liquid that I have here. If the player would mouse over, it would be able to see how much amount of that liquid he needs. So this is pretty much a full item that works. Over here, I have a mana crafting. So this is really, really similar to RF crafting, because in your tiers, you're going to write mana, and then you're going to have mana per tick. And then this thing here is going to be the mana per tick. So your total mana that you're going to use is going to be your mana multiplied by your timer. So it's going to be 4,000 mana for this recipe here. So it is quite simple. It is like the others, except that you put mana and mana per tick. Say here, I made an iron pickaxe and I left the empty spaces. Over here, I made just a shapeless of one item. So you can really do the item as you want. It is not hard. What I will do for you guys is I will put this in a file that I will upload onto my pastebin, and you will be able to just take a look at these. They're just random recipes that I made to be able to show everyone what you can do with the mod, and I hope you guys enjoy the file. There will also be a link to the wiki from MCGT. And you will be also able to see a little bit of everything. I think in there was no information about the NBT, which I asked him for it. And he was kind enough to tell me how to use it. So everything is there for you. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little thing. And this is how you can customize everything in this mod to help you make the best mod pack ever that you could ever make. Well, guys, this is it. So If you have any questions, you can ask them in the comment section below, and I will try to answer them as best as I can. If you have any issue, you can write them on the issue tracker that I linked to this description. If you have really in-depth questions, probably better that you go ask MC Jetty. I did link his Twitter in the description below, and you could also probably ask him on the issue tracker with, instead of bug, it would be more of a question or something like that. But if you enjoyed this mod spotlight, don't forget to leave a like. If you loved it, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.